Hello, everyone. Did you know that the red color infuriates bulls? Or that hair and nails continue to grow after death? Also, that UK is the rainiest country? And that it's dangerous to wake up sleepwalkers? Or maybe those are all silly myths that you and I believe in for some reason. Let's get to the bottom of this and debunk some very popular misconceptions. Let's go! Let's start with a scene we've all seen in films. A character in an action movie shoots the gas tank of a car and it blows up right away. Yeah, movie makers love to make up spectacular scenes that have nothing to do with real life. Although in theory it is possible, but it requires a completely impossible combination of circumstances. For example, the shooter must first shoot through the gas tank in such a way that the petrol vapors fill the vehicle's interior evenly, then wait a little while, and then make a very precise shot into a certain part of the car to produce a spark. In practice, none of the dozens of YouTube videos attempting to recreate Hollywood's ultimate special effect worked. But if the screenwriters had not disregarded the laws of physics, we would have been deprived of too many spectacular movie endings. Now let's visit a bullfight. You can see the matador waving his red cloak, making the bull angry. The truth is that bulls have dichromatic vision, which means they don't care whether it's a red or green cape. It's all the same for them. The matador's cloak is red, simply because that's what the original matadors used to wear. It is also beautiful and well visible even from the farthest stance. Let's move on. It is said that people's hair and nails continue to grow even after they die. In fact, it's quite the opposite. They do not change in size, but the dead body begins to actively release fluid, dry out, and accordingly decrease in size. This gives the illusion that the nails and hair are growing. Let's travel back to early 19th century France. Everyone believes that the famous general and emperor Napoleon Bonaparte was very short, except that he was about 170 centimeters tall, which back then was just above average. There are several reasons for this myth. First, even at the age of 26, during his military campaign, Napoleon was known as the Little Corporal, but only because of his young age. Secondly, historians believe that it might have been due to confusion in the length measurements of the time. Napoleon's known height was 5 feet and 2 inches, but at that time the French foot and inch were slightly bigger than the English ones, so the English might have counted only 157 centimeters when converting his height. By the way, in 19th century England there were widespread caricatures of the French emperor, where he was portrayed as a short man. Another reason for the myth is that Napoleon always wore a modest bicorn hat on his head and did not wear heels, while people around him wore high hats and high heels to seem more important. Next to them, of course, the emperor seemed smaller. Since we've already mentioned Great Britain, let's talk about a very popular myth about it. Some people always say that this is the rainiest country in the world, but this is only a myth. The reason is that in the UK it rains throughout the year in small but frequent batches, whereas in Italy, for example, rains are rare, but when it does rain, it's pretty harsh. If you take the statistics of the average annual rainfall, UK is not even in the top 10. Now a trick question. A peanut is a nut, right? Some of you might even know it as an earth nut. Well, yes, it is called that sometimes, but a peanut is not a nut at all. In fact, it is the seed of an herbaceous legume plant that matures underground. Another question, which fruit holds the record for vitamin C content? Well, you would probably say lemon, and you would be very wrong. Everyone should know that 100 grams of lemon has only 40 milligrams of vitamin C. This is very little compared to, for example, parsley, which has 150 milligrams, a kiwi has 180, and a bell pepper has 250. But the record holder of vitamin C content are rose hips. It contains as much as 650 milligrams in 100 grams. By the way, if you don't know yet, we have a mobile game about Super Tony. You have to play as our hero, fight monsters, and overcome various obstacles. Try it, you will not regret it. You can download it using the link in the description. The last myth is that you should never wake a sleepwalker during their nightly adventures. It is said that it may even kill them. I can state with absolute certainty that this is all nonsense. Sleepwalkers even need to be awakened. How do I know, you ask? Yes, it's just that Tony and I have conducted an entire investigation on this topic and explained everything in great detail in one of our videos. If you are interested, then you should definitely watch it. The link is on the screen right now, and also in the description. Well, tell us in the comments, what other ridiculous myths do you know? Let me warn you right off the bat, the myth that your math teacher is a monster from another planet is not a myth at all, so don't be shy and share your stories, and the best comments will be featured in the next video. See you next week with another interesting episode of Super Tony. Bye!